Hey there, so I got myself a new laser cutter. This is a Mecpow X5, and I thought of doing a little bit of a first look, unboxing and all of that type of a video, since there wasn't really much information on it. I guess because it got released a couple months back in December 2023, maybe November. And there's just a couple videos in Dutch by affiliates, I believe. So let's just take a look at it and see what it does. This specific machine is a Mecpow X5. Initially, I had been looking at Sculpfun S30 Ultra or Creality Falcon 2 or maybe Atomstack A20 Max, because I want a nice big cutting area. But kind of by chance, I ran across this one and I was a little bit skeptical because there wasn't really much noise about it online, and features that looked really, really decent. The build quality as well, at least from the photos, it looked like kind of on par or better than the Sculpfun version that I wanted to get. But the price was a lot cheaper. So this ran for about 480 euros, while the Sculpfun with a honeycomb bed would have been around 810 euros if I bought the bed from them. So that's like a 65% discount. So I just couldn't really help myself and I went for it. And I must say, I'm not disappointed. It arrived fast. The assembly was really easy, 20 minutes, something like that. So first impressions, the build quality is really solid. It's a proper aluminium body all over the place. The parts fit together well, no misalignments, no problems, no issues whatsoever. Of course, you need a nice sturdy enclosure and a big one because it is a big cutter. I built mine out of plywood, works nice and sturdy. It's keeps in the fumes. The machine itself is a 22 watt diode laser, 600x600 millimeters honeycomb bent. It has a little nice control panel with a lock so you can turn off the controls. It has a stop button, a little bit of a flame detection and alarm that goes along with that. Then it has extra ports, so if you want to power a fan or some lights with 24 volts, or it even has a little plug for detecting if the lid is closed or not. I guess it turns off the laser most likely when that happens. And it also has some limit switches, making sure that the laser head is always in the right position. Yeah, it seems really nice and solid. First tests I run, I plan to use it mainly on 4 millimeters HDF, a bit of plywood, a bit of carton, leather, paper, things like that. And it passes everything through in one go, no problem. Engraving as well, you can run it really, really fast, no issues there. For the software, it runs Lightroom and Gerbil, or whatever the other thing was, and it has its own software as well, but I'm not planning to use that, so yeah, doesn't matter. Yes, what else? I added these lovely little LED strips on the inside. I think that's a nice touch, very easy upgrade. So I got this machine specifically because it has a large cutting area. I must say it was really rare to actually find machines with this large area or larger. I think larger, I found maybe one or two machines, the same area, maybe a couple of them. And this one was definitely the cheapest, so hell yes, why not? 20 watt laser over 30 watt. 20 watt is perfectly fine. This actually has a 30 watt version if you do want it, but for me, I don't do a lot of production or anything. I do prototyping, so having to do multiple passes instead of one, not a problem. And I get a thinner line and 2/3 of the price. Very good. It also has air assist, which I think it's really, really nice and vital to have nice and clean lines. You can run it hotter and on more flammable materials. I like that a lot. And yeah, it just works nice and smooth, no problems. So super happy with that. Also, if you want to buy one, first look on Google for discounts, because it seems like the standard price of 660 euros is a bit of a gimmick, where there always seems to be like a 25% campaign running somewhere. So just take a look before you would. But yeah, so far, really good first impressions. I'm looking forward to using it a lot. It feels like it's actually a smooth process where I will be more likely to use it compared to my old crappy machine. Yeah, first impressions are great. Solid build quality, nice and smooth, no issues, very happy with it.